Good morning, children. This is Amir Ramachandran. Today I am going to teach 10th class English grammar, that is related to unit 4 grammar, that it is. And you see, children, yesterday's previous class you have come to same unit of grammar, that it is unit 4 only, but it is given to you section 1, 2 prepositions with blanks. Those are given, that blanks sentences, you filled up them. Now you also open your textbook. It is better to have the textbook in your hands. That is the third bit which is given following to the B which is given there in part 2. That is what you call it, bit number 2, that it is B. Now we are coming to third bit. You take your textbook and also a notebook. Better to have the notebook in your hands. What is given to you, third bit? Read the following paragraph and notice the use of the past perfect and simple past tense. So some sentences are given to you in a textbook. Some sentences are given to you, underlined words are given to you. You have to notice them first of all. That what you have to notice them, which sentence is in simple past tense and which is in past perfect. You have to identify first the underlined words. You have to notice and you have to identify them. What I want to tell you, first of all, before going to understand this third bit section A, that it is third bit A section, this is, you must know what is simple past tense, what is past perfect tense. This kind of grammar part is given to you in the previous class also. Now again I am coming to that, what is simple past tense? Simple past tense is nothing but, it's a structure will be like a subject V2 plus object. And when do we use this simple past tense? In simple past tense, verb shows its action. Simply, action took place in the past. Where what it shows here? Some action took place in the past. That it is also called indefinite tense. Simple past tense is also called indefinite tense. Here, only verb 2 we use there. And we are not going to tell when particularly happened that. Simply, we are going to tell that yesterday and in the past, last year, last week. This like we are going to use. Sentences, end of the tour. Clue words will come that yesterday, 2 or 1 week ago, and 2 days ago, this like will come there. Last year or last month, this like clue words will come there in a sentence, particular sentence. Then we are going to use the simple past tense. That means a subject comes, a V2, and some object we use there. Do you understand this? These are the clue words will come in a sentence, and then we use the simple past tense. So I'm coming to that particularly what I'm telling that subjects means what are they? Subjects are I, persons, first person, second person, third person are there. So in first person what will come? I and you. Sorry, I and we. In first person what will come there? I and we will come here. First person pronouns these are. Is it okay? Singular and plural. Second person, you. Third person, singulars, he, she, it. And plural form is they. In third person, this is the first person, this is the second person, third person. So these are persons here. Pronouns will come here. So instead of these pronouns, instead of these persons, we may also use some nouns, proper nouns also. We can use the names of the persons, names of some places that like we can use here. I'm coming to that. I taught English yesterday. So here, what is the clue? Taught is V2. Yesterday is the clue word given to you. So simple past tense it is used here. Same like that here, according to the persons, according to the subject, we can use. For all subjects, V2 is used in simple past tense. For all subjects, V2 is used in simple past tense. Do you understand this? That is called the simple past tense. What it tells you? Simple past tense, it shows, the verb shows an action, it took place in past. And indefinite it is, not a definite. Am I right? Now, one more thing you have to know in this grammar part. Past perfect. What is past perfect? Past perfect structure is like this. Subject had V3 plus object. So, subjects already you know that. And had is a past form of have. Have, had, had. That it is. Helping verb that it is. And V3 we have to use there. Verb 3, past participle we have to use there. Then, in which situation we use the past perfect tense? Past perfect tense is used in that tense. Verb shows an action which completed before some certain time in the past. Before certain time in the past. Certain time means what do you think there? Yesterday generally we are talking, this is the past tense. Or last week it is the past tense. Last year it is the past tense. There, some certain point of time, before that certain point of time, past perfect tense is used. You understand that? Sometimes when we are discussing the two actions of the past, two actions of the past, when we are going to discuss in a single sentence, we have to prefer to that before, first what happened, before going to somewhere, before going to do something, which action took place first. For that, we are going to use the past perfect. For example, you see, yesterday I went to bus stand. I went to bus stand. When I went to bus stand yesterday, comma, but the bus had left, before few minutes. What do you understand this? Went is V2, had left is also past tense only. But here what we are going to say that past perfect tense is used before some certain time of something happened. I went to bus stand. This is simple past tense. So before I went to bus stand, what happened there? Bus had left, already left that. So before going to bus stand, some other action took place there. That it is the past perfect tense. I repeat that. When two actions complete in the past tense, when we discuss about the two actions in the sentence of past tense, one is used in simple past tense, another is used in the past perfect tense. Past perfect tense, it is going to show you some point of time, before some point of time, before certain time, some action had taken place. So, in two actions, which thing had happened first? For that, we use that past perfect tense. You understand? So, this kind of sentences come here in the past tense. After knowing this, what is simple past tense? What is the past perfect tense? In textbook, children, you take your textbook, observe the textbook then, what are given to you. Third bit that it is in grammar part. I am going to read them out. All of you see there in your textbook. Are you ready then? So that it is, this exercise I am going to read them. You see and try to find out that which is simple past tense, which is past perfect. I have not written here. You see in your textbook there. A, that it is. As all the actors had taken their positions, the curtain rose. In this first sentence, simple past tense, which part is simple past tense, which part is past perfect tense? Can you say that? Had taken their position. This is the past perfect. And next one is rose, is underlined. This is the simple past tense. So, as all the actors had taken their positions, the curtain rose. Which thing happened first here? Sitting, taking their positions. That is why I had taken their positions. It is written in the past perfect tense. After that incident only curtain rose. That is the second action. So first action is taking their position. Second action is rose, the curtain. Curtain rose. So first action which took place, for that past perfect is used. Second action late which taken place, for that we use the simple past tense. That is V2. You see the second sentence? They started acting as the director had asked them to. So they started acting, and as the director had asked them to. So which one happened first here? First director asked them to do that action. Next only the actors they started. So first which took place, for that had plus V3 it is used here. Third sentence, you see, after full stop. The audience enjoyed the play very much. The hero kicked the comedian since the comedian had done mischievous things. First he did that one. That is why this is written in the past perfect tense. The musician fell off his chair after the comedian had fallen on him. So first who had fallen here? Comedian. So that it is written in the past perfect. Next what happened, that it is given in the simple past tense. The power went off after the musician had landed on the cables. First of all, what happened here? Musician had landed on the cables. So that is why it is a past perfect tense. Next what happened, that it is a power went off. First action is a musician had fallen, landed. Second one, power went off. Next sentence. There was darkness and silence everywhere. There was, simple past tense, was. There were, there was, past tense. After a while, two persons in the audience started a conversation. These two are given in simple past tense. Okay, now? Now, after this, you see that next bit given to you. I'm coming to the next bit. Better to see in your textbook than B. It is given to you. Ready? Read the following conversation and fill in the blanks with appropriate verb forms. That is past perfect tense or simple past tense. That is in past perfect tense or simple past tense. So the blanks are given to you in conversation. You see that conversation. I'm going to read out that conversation. Ready? That is, what is that? Sarath is telling. Wow, what dash happen in bracket given to you? Everything dash in bracket B given to you. Disturbed before the play dash to an end. So this is the sentence given to you. So can you guess that? First blank, what will come here? Happen? What happened? That is the simple past tense. Everything had disturbed before the play came to an end. V2, last one is V2. So here which one happened first? For that had plus V3 it is used. Bharat saying like this. Damn it. The play dash very interesting. In bracket what is given? B. It's a B form you have to use. It is a first B form is was. The play was very interesting. Someone on the stage dash in bracket do given then something when the hero dash in bracket throw him off given to you. So first one was written there B form. Second blank what will come here? Had done something. And the next one also lost the third one. That it is the hero threw him off. Simple past tense that it was there. Okay. Next Sarath says I2- in bracket C given to you. It. That means I2 saw it. Verb 2 is used. Verb 2. I2 saw it. It was the comedian. The hero dash in bracket given to you. What is called that it is a hurt. The hero hurt him since he dash do mischievous things. Thing. So second one also it is a past tense only. Hurt. It is not hurted. Hurt only. Hurt him since he had done. Since he had done. That is a past perfect. Bharat, how disgusting, he says. I-100 rupees before I-enter given to you. First blank is pay, second blank is enter given to you. I repeat, how disgusting. I-100 rupees. I had paid 100 rupees before I entered this theater. Before I entered the theater, this theater. So first what happened there? He paid something. That is had paid. Next, what happened? He entered the theater. So, next one is a simple past tense. Next, Sharon says, where dash in bracket B given there. Where dash the director? That means, where was the director? Had he dash tried, it is a simple past tense. To set things right before the audience dash started. Started given to you, started. Leaving, it would have been nice. Bharat says here, the electrician dash restore, had restored the power before the audience leave given to you left, that it is left. The audience left, thank God, at last the play resumed, at last the play continued. This is bit 2 given to you. So next remaining grammar part, let me see that in the next video.